Alright guys, I have returned. Now the air conditioner is on for right now. I went for a pee. The air conditioner's on because it's hot as hell in here and I need some air while we sit back and read all this new shit that we've discovered. Holy crap, was that a crazy freaking venture, guys. Freaking crazy. I guess we should probably eat some stuff first. We found mercury before, didn't we? I don't remember it looking like that. In fact, it did not look like that. I know for a fact it didn't look like that. Well, maybe it did. I don't know. Right, let's go get some food quick. Now, let's do a little bit of reading. Okay, let's see. First of all, we got a new blueprint. Okay, so we can make synthetic fibers, which takes that benzene stuff, or benzene stuff. And I can grow that, I believe. So that's good. So now I can make that suit, which I'm definitely going to make. But what is this new blueprint that we have? Prawn suit drill arm, diamond, lithium, and titanium. I can make that. Enables the mining of resources. Hell yes. And then we have the torpedo arm, which I only found one piece of, unfortunately. Okay, voice log. So what did we find? So voice logs were the ecological biome. Yeah, okay. Short-range scans show a cave system rich in fossilized remains beneath this area. They keep telling me fossilized remains. Right, databank, 20 new things. Holy mother of butt sack. Alright, well, let's see some of the new sea stuff. So we got Gabe's Feather. This plant grows almost exclusively in deeper waters, where its hand-like leaves have evolved to filter sediment from the environment. It is likely dependent on the excretions of fauna populating, populating the waters above and around it. So it eats poop. We got the ghost weed, grows exclusively in deep waters where its pale pigmentation is visible of the fewest wavelengths. Or on the fewest wavelengths. Crab claw kelp, a blue-tipped kelp species which tends to grow in or near to acidic brine pools on the ocean floor. So that's what those green things are, they're brine pools. Acidic, that would explain why it was killing me. These brine pools are hazardous to most life forms. However, the crab claw has adapted to by developing a thick, inflexible root system, which can withstand the environment and which raises the sensitive blue feeding nodules, okay, above the level of the brine. The brine lily. This is obviously what was floating in it. These lily-like plants have evolved to take advantage of the relative density of the acidic brine pools encountered near the ocean floor to float safely on the surface. Tendril-like roots extend down into the brine, drawing essential salts and minerals from the water. Exploitable. Let's see. Bloodroot. These root systems generally extend from one cave wall to another. One coiled root system where this root breaks is open water, its tendrils coil around and enhance structural integrity. Cave wall rooting, where the root meets the cave wall, it penetrates into the rock and continues to grow. Albeit at a slower rate. Both blood roots and blood vines produce blood oil pustules, okay, confirming that they are in fact one and the same flora species. The majority of the root system thrives within the rock itself, occasionally breaking into open water to reach untapped mineral resources or generating vines which feed on the water-based nutrients. Blood vine. Oh, look, it's the butthole thing that eats, apparently, because it's got little teeth, apparently. Great, that's just apparently. This species of kelp grows in sparse... Something's in my ear. Collapses. Deep on the ocean floor. They keep saying ocean floor. Were we as deep as we could go? I doubt it. And provides shelter for an array of distinct fauna and megafauna. Oh, megafauna. What is megafauna? Can we not talk about megafauna? Because that means big things that eat me. I'm trying to adjust my freaking headset here. Survival at these depths is challenging, and the life forms which make their homes have developed unusual coping mechanisms, including a bleaching of skin pigment, dependency on naturally occurring metals and oils to adjust to temperature and pressure, and in some cases even electrical defense mechanisms. The vibrant red oils which seep from the blood vine coagulate into semi-hard pustules, which frequently fall loose and form a vital foodstuff for the local ecosystem, or are otherwise reabsorbed into the ground over time. The deep shroom. I want to know what this is. A discolored relative of the acid mushroom, adapted to low-light conditions, considerably more acidic than its shallow-dwelling cousin. I think it's supposed to be than its shallow-dwelling cousin. It may have applications in advanced fabrication. Can be processed into hydrochloric acid. I don't know what we would need that for, but I'm assuming we're going to need it for something. All right. Now that was flora. Now what about fauna? Because we found lots of fauna. Let's see. Scavengers and parasites. The amoeba is a fauna, apparently. A simple non-sentient organism found attached to land with high levels of fossilized organic matter. It feeds on this matter until it reaches maturity, at which point it divides it to create two new genetically identical offspring, and the cycle continues. What about herbivores? The ghost ray. Genetic analysis indicates this specimen is a close cousin of the jelly ray, adapted to deep sea conditions. Unlike that species, its body is fully protected by a translucent skin, and its large wings are capable of generating considerable thrust. Highly poisonous flesh, docile, feeds on plant matter that has settled on the seafloor. Inedible assessment, of course. Deceased. I feel like that's that one thing. We'll look at that here. What about carnivores? The ampule. This is that shock creature. A large, inquisitive predator found inhabiting the deeper waters of the reefs and bulb bush colonies. Strong and territorial, torso-mounted prongs appear capable of generating a powerful electric current. Ampule has been recorded using electricity to incapacitate its prey. If a faster, stronger, and hungrier predator lives on the reefs, it appears to avoid the ampule. So, in other words, it's dangerous as fuck. The crab squid. Now this is curious here. Ugh. The crab squid. This large predator can be found in deep waters, where it lurks amongst the blood kelp and membrane trees in search of prey. 10 limbs feature different appendages for swimming, walking, and offensive behavior. Feeds on small fish, which are identified in the murky waters through a combination of smell and light sensitivity. Attraction to light sources suggests jelly rays and spinefish may be amongst its natural prey. Aggressive when approached. Assessment, avoid. There's that ghost leviathan thing. We'll read that here in a second. River prowler. Now this is curious here. A fast, agile predator discovered at great depths. Powerful jaws used for both savaging prey and warding off larger predators. Its torso is high vulnerable. Okay. Consisting predominantly of spinal column and cartilage. Doesn't it mean highly vulnerable then? It will aggressively keep its jaws facing its opponent, but smaller, faster life forms may have the advantage. Assessment, avoid. The mesmer. Okay, this is that creature that basically, I guess, keeps you from looking away from it. Small carnivorous life form with a unique hunting mechanism that enables it to hypnotize its foes. Outer wings. A mesmer swims using its outer wings, which can be angled upwards to forward its prey. Tiny lenses on the surface can be tilted independently to create mesmerizing patterns which flood the victim's brain with enticing messages, delivered in whatever form is most convincing to the target. Outer shell. The mesmer can open the jaw-like recess and its protective outer shell in order to, error 463, share its beauty. Do not resist. Assessment, draw closer. Bull fucking shit. And oh my goodness, that thing is weird as hell looking. Look at this, the ghost leviathan juvenile. This vast predator has adapted to live in deep waters and dark cave systems, hunting anything and everything. Soft outer membrane and elongated body enable navigation of tight cave environments. Length measures in excess of all reaper leviathans encountered. I haven't encountered a single reaper leviathan. I guess that means they expect you to encounter a reaper leviathan before you encounter this thing. Well, I guess I'm the first person on the planet that has not happened to, because I have not seen a single Reaper Leviathan. in this entire playthrough so far, and we played like over 20 hours on this play file. The specimen is still growing and shows no indication of stopping. Assessment of void. Great. That means there are bigger ones. Deceased. Sea dragon skeleton. The semi-intact skeletal structure of a Leviathan-class predator. Head trauma. There is clear evidence of a massive physical trauma to the head. The damage is so severe it was likely the cause of death, and must have occurred somewhere nearby. Damage is consistent with a high-speed collision with a solid object. Number 2. Age. Something in the environment has helped to preserve these remains, but calcium decay suggests an approximate time of death 1,000 years ago. Holy nutsack. Bone growth suggests the creature was in an egg-laying stage of its life cycle. The sea dragon. Well, thank God it's deceased by this point. I don't need to be fucking worrying about sea dragons and shit. Coral. Pyrocoral. This coral species is unlike any other encountered on 4546B, insofar as it relies on magma flow rather than water current to deliver nutrients. As lava rises up from the planet's core and erupts at vents, this coral forms around the base until eventually it surrounded the entire vent. Lava is then funneled up through the coral, allowing it to siphon minerals and heat as it goes. There's still 5 things left. Geological data. Crystalline sulfur. Sulfur is a highly reactive non-metallic element, usually found in abundance underground. Common applications include production of acidic compounds and combustibles. Assessment: essential component for particular vehicle modifications. Mercury ore, a common low-value cinnabar ore, which can be processed into liquid mercury, has a range of applications, including continued use in temperature measurement, essential for Cyclops fire suppression. Assessment. Nickel ore. Nickel is a medium-hard ductile metal used extensively in production of strong metal alloys. It has applications throughout the construction industry. Assessment. Useful in advanced vehicle modification. And uranium is a naturally occurring uranium oxide, highly radioactive and unstable. Its primary use is in the production of uranium reactor rods for nuclear reactors, or generators. Applications in nuclear power. Assessment. And then we have an advanced theory. Specimen with symptoms of unknown infection. The organism is displaying signs of an unknown bacterial infection. Blisters are bright green, forming networks around infection sites. What? Pathology suggests a waterborne bacterium capable of penetrating the body through the skin. Underlying indications of minor genetic mutation and aggressive behavior. The bacterium itself is unlike any so far recorded in human exploration. Further information cannot be synthesized at this time. Warning, may be contagious. Avoid. Do not under any circumstances consume the flesh. What the fuck is wrong with me? We scanned the blighter, or whatever it was called, which was like a different biter. And it's not in there as me having scanned it. I think it must have been infected, and we scanned it, and instead of giving me the scan of the actual blighter itself, it gave me a scan of the infection. Infected. Yeah. Great. Just fucking glorious. Holy mother of hell. Oh, that's right. Wait. Hello? It is clearly either an alien trying to speak to me, or it's just an audio that's been cut out. That's great. That makes me feel just freaking fantastic. Okay, now, in other news, we have stuff to plant. Thank you.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Exterior module. Oh, we can freaking grow these things. Okay, some of that stuff in there. This blood shit growing, because I remember seeing that required for some of my creations. I guess we have a full thing here of that shit. Oh yeah, remember, these things give me water. Okay, and then I'm gonna wait for these to grow, and then I'll plant more of these shroomers. Make sure I take the right screenshots here. We could probably go to that Degassi base. I bet you my ass we could go there, because we were at like 800 meters depth. Or some shit. Wait. 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 Cave system with extensive fossil extensive fossil record southwest of enforcement platform, 800 meters depth. We found it. We found the disease research facility, and we didn't fucking enter it. You've gotta be twisting my dick on a fucking Thursday night. Son of a bitch. We're going right back there once I'm done here. I don't have anything for nickel. Okay, we have our new resources stored. Oops. Is there any water fabricated? Yes. Good. It's good to have at least two water on hand. Now, let me see here. 3 diamond, 1 lithium, and 5 titanium. I think we need to go on another titanium run.
Systems online.
Looking for it. That guy's getting loud again. Oh, because he's right there, mate. He's right foot in there. He can fuck right off. Fuck him. Hey, stalkers, would you happen to know where some metal salvage is? I saw the sign. And it opened up my ass. Fuck! Data box. Realize there were any data boxes. There's a metal salvage right over there. There's clearly more metal salvage scattered around, but it's probably not going. Yeah, see, it's starting to detect more. Well, I'm gonna let that do its thing while we go and try and find some of this stuff. So there's some up that direction and some over that direction. There it is. Oh, there's two. Hold on for a second here. But yeah, it detects a lot of salvage over in that creep area. Search for this data box. There's a data box over there that we didn't grab before? What the fuck? It's out on the edge of the creepvine zone. It's probably something we already have, but hey, you know what? Yeah, it was out this direction. What exactly it was is another... Oh, here. Sorry. I guess I could have turned the air conditioner off. I completely forgot it was even on. Where was it from here? It was on the surface. It wasn't down in the cave. Bet it slipped right under our noses of it being out here in this region. So I'd assume that this is where it was pointing. There's lots of salvage here. Just keep an eye open for that data box. It might be inside. Out here, but it's not too useful for us, honestly. Assume that it's on the inside here somewhere. It is. It's this one. The one that's already been taken. So, like, what the hell, man? Let's head back. I feel like we got enough titanium, more than enough, in fact.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I only needed a little bit of titanium, so it's not like this big trip was necessary, but seeing that, you know, we'll be working on further base expansions in the future, I'm gonna end up at that point where I need a shitload of titanium again, and at least this will put me in that region so that I have enough already. Thank you. think that that's where that's telling me. I'm just trying to make sure that that's at the right area. Man, we've got two full containers and we're starting to fill up the third container. That just goes to show that that was a very, very successful run. Wait. Okay, now, I was trying to make this. So, 5 titanium. Here? No. Because I make it in at the station itself. Yes, right here. Prawn suit modules. Damn, I need 3 for that stuff. How does this work now? It doesn't let me.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Yeah, it doesn't let me, it's not letting me edit it. How do you do the edits? Oh, access upgrades, just a little wonky. I see, so now I've got a drill. Now, wasn't there some resources around here somewhere? A resource pack or whatever. Because I want to test this out. There was, wasn't there? Swore there was. Fuck off. I bet I can drill him to death. It's probably not the most practical thing in the world. There's fucking metal salvage right there. I thought that there was like a salt deposit here.
Emergency. Starvation imminent.
Ah, shit.
Seek calorie intake immediately.
Alright. Okay, bit wonky. I guess this is what I need that jet upgrade for.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Vital signs stabilizing. Holy shit, are they grown yet? No, they're only 89%. What about you guys? Eye stalks. Ghost weed's not fully grown. Ah, these guys are, though. I love this, that you can plant your own shit. Why wasn't this in the game?